seems the letter is, it's more like everything you need is contained in the pure word. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and from the Son, who comes to seek and save the lost.
Amen.
Let us pray together. Almighty
God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthy magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We sing our first hymn, Longing for Light in the Age of Darkness.
Thank you.
such a meal. God is love, and we are his children. There is no room for fear in love. We love because he loved us first. So let us confess our sins, penitence, and faith. God our Father,
we confess to you and to our fellow members in the body of Christ that in our sin, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do, we are truly sorry. Forgive us our sins and deliver us from the power of evil, for the sake of your Son who died for us, Jesus Christ our Lord.
God, our Father, we thank you that you are both power and love, that you forgive us and free us from all our sins, that you heal and you strengthen us by your Spirit, and that you raise us to new life in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Say together the collect. God of truth, help us to be merciful and to walk in grace with wisdom, proclaiming the good news of Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen. Please remain seated as Tricia leads us in the first reading.
The epistle is taken from the book of Romans, chapter 4, verses 18 to 25. Against all hope, Abraham in hope believed, and so became the father of many nations, just as it had been promised to him. Without weakening in his faith, he faced the fact that his body was as good as dead, since he was about 100 years old, and that Sarah's womb was also dead. Yet he did not waver through unbelief regarding the promise of God, but was strengthened in his faith and gave glory to God, being fully persuaded that God has the power to do what he had promised. This is why it is said that it was credited to him as righteousness by his faith. The words "it was credited to him" were written not for him alone, but also for us, to whom God will credit righteousness. For us who believe in him who raised Jesus our Lord from the dead. He was delivered over to death for our sins and was raised to life for our justification. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand to sing our first or second hymn, "The Lord Has Come to You."
Come to you.
news of our risen Lord according to Matthew.
Glory to Christ our Savior.
As Jesus went on from there, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the tax collector's booth. Follow me, he told him. And Matthew got up and followed him. While Jesus was having dinner at Matthew's house, many tax collectors and sinners came and ate with him and his disciples. However, when the Pharisees saw this, they asked his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" On hearing this, Jesus said, "It is not the healthy who need a doctor, but those who are ill. But go and learn what this means. I desire mercy, not sacrifice, for I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners." While he was saying this, a synagogue leader came and knelt before him and said, "My daughter has just died, but come and put your hand on her, and she will live." Jesus immediately got up and went with him, and so did his disciples. As he left the house, a woman who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years came up behind him and touched the edge of his cloak. She said to herself, "If I only touch his cloak, I will be healed." Jesus turned and saw her. "Take heart, daughter, your faith has healed you." And the woman was healed at that moment. When Jesus entered the synagogue leader's house and saw the noisy crowd and the people playing pipes, he said, "Go away. This girl is not dead, but asleep." But they laughed at him. After the crowd had been put outside, he went in and took the girl by the hand, and she got up. News of this spread through all that region. Give thanks to the Lord for his glorious gospel.
Praise to Christ our Lord.
Production director says I'm sitting, standing in the right place now.
Well, will you stay here?
I won't stay here. Shall we pray? Father God, we thank you for your great love towards us, that our faith can indeed be truly placed in you, for though you are the one who is faithful. We thank you too, Lord, that you are merciful. God who shows mercy, even though we may not deserve it. And even further than that, Lord, you're the God of grace, who gives us more than we could ever imagine and desire. So by your Spirit, guide us in our thoughts and what is said and done to your praise. Please do be seated. I desire mercy, not sacrifice, might be the key passage from our readings this morning. I want to tackle three enormous subjects. I hopefully do that within 10 minutes. We're just going to scratch the surface, aren't we? I want to look at three words that are regularly used within our worship, within our walk as Christian people. And I feel those three words are reflected in the passages that we read today. The first word is the word faith. Faith. What is faith, you might ask? Yeah. Are you up for some exercises? No, I can see you're all eager to do this. Okay, quickly turn to the person next to you. Might be okay, you're absolutely okay. And ask the question, what is faith? But now you've got an answer. Have you got an answer? No? Em, do you want to give me an answer?
Trust in the God unseen.
Trust in the God unseen. Excellent. Faith can be explained or defined as to place or put your confidence or trust in something. So you might look at a chair and think, I have confidence that even though I'm overweight, this chair is going to hold me. A good amount of time that chair will thankfully hold you, but occasionally there is those dodgy ones out there. With God, it's about having that confidence, that faith, that trust that God is there, the unseen God, and that the promises that he has given will come to pass. Think of Abraham and Sarah. God leads them out from their own land and gives them a promise that they will become the father, the mother of many generations. And rightly so, Sarah laughs. Come on, God, look at me. I'm well past it. You know, and she just laughs when she hears that she's going to bear a child. But in faith, they hold on. And through that faith, it becomes accredited to them. In their bank account of life, they are rewarded as being righteous before God. They're not perfect people. They don't always do it right. They were probably frustrated that they had to wait so long to have a child. But in faith, they trusted, and in faith, that promise came true. How often do we treat God like a fairy godmother or some sort of genie out of a bottle? We go and say, Lord, if you do this for me, that'd be great. Thanks, amen. Thinking that God's going to go, poof, there you go, there's your pumpkin carriage, off you go to the ball. God, I'm sad to say, sometimes frustrates the out of me. Sometimes it's like sitting at the traffic lights. Sometimes God does say, go. A lot of times it does feel as though God says, yeah, you can go soon, but not yet. And other times it's as though God says, whoa, Peter, don't go there, not yet. God and faith. To put our faith in God that he has our best desire at our heart. He wants the best for us. Even though at times we may think, where are you? Why is this happening? Where are we going next? To trust in the journey through faith. Our next word. Mercy. Hopefully that's an easier one for you to quickly discuss. Go. What is mercy? Mercy is when you're sitting there and the preacher at the front is rabbiting on and all you want to do is say, shut up, Peter, and go on with it.
We haven't finished yet.
Mercy. Mercy. About not giving out what is deserved. Think of the criminal receiving a sentence, a punishment. A judgment is passed, but the judge then says, yes, you're guilty, but I write it off. The punishment, the payment is paid. Mercy. All of us have received mercy from God. All of us have been out of step with God. Like sheep, we've gone astray. But God is a good shepherd. He is merciful. He does not abandon us or just leave us. He comes searching for us, seeking us out. That's why we have the story of Christ, Jesus coming, being born amongst us. It's God's mercy at work, wanting to seek us out, to tell us that, okay, yes, you've made a mistake. It wrong, but I forgive you. I restore you. In our gospel passage, we have this interesting little verse that says, I desire mercy, not sacrifice. Have you received mercy? Your sins being forgiven? Have you heard that God loves you? If we've received those things, then in return God wants us to do likewise. And the problem that Jesus encounters is that there's this beautiful people of faith who have then taken this beautiful gift of God and they've went, locked it all up and said, well, actually, if you want to know that God loves you, you've got to turn up with a nice hat on your head. Because all women should wear hats and cover their heads in worship. Okay? If you're going to turn up for worship, then you better be circumcised. And there's rules after rules after rules after rules. And they take the temple and they turn it from a place of wonder and awe to becoming a great idol. It becomes more about where the candle sits. Is it in the right place at the right time? Is the right colour on the altar? Does it matter where the altar sits? I know I'm getting controversial now and we've got trouble over coffee and tea. But we become so fixated that we forget that the priority, what God calls us to do, is firstly to love and show mercy, remembering that we are loved, and out of that love, tell others that they are loved. But the good news is more than just about having faith in a God. It's more than just believing that that God is merciful. There's also the word grace. A beautiful word for a beautiful daughter. Sorry, my daughter's called Grace, if you didn't know that. And Grace graduated. Because Grace has given us more than we could ever imagine. And that's what the word grace means. We are receiving more than we actually deserve. We don't deserve mercy, but by faith in God we receive mercy, we receive forgiveness. And because we've put our faith in God, He is merciful and does forgive us, but He does more. He grants graduates us. He lifts us up. No longer just subjects, no longer servants, but lifts us up and places upon us a great robe of righteousness and calls us as sons and daughters to come to a table, to come and meet with him as princes and princesses of the kingdom of God. When I was growing up, I was told that GRACE is an acronym. It stands for God's riches at Christ's expense. We are blessed, given the free gift of God, but the free gift comes at the price of the life and death and resurrection of the Son. So as we come again to table, as we draw near to God, we come with faith, receiving mercy, going away filled with hope in a God who gives us more purpose in life and promises us that through Christ there is a place for all of us through God's riches at Christ's expense. Amen.
Please stand as we declare together a declaration of faith. As the body of Christ, we declare our faith together. We believe
in one God, the Father, who of every family in heaven and on earth is named.
We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love.
We believe in God, the Holy Spirit,
who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Please sit on your prayer intercessions.
Faith we come, O Lord. We draw near. Knowing that we should be barred from your presence, but in your mercy, you welcome us in. Hear us, Lord, as we share our prayers this day, those that are spoken, and more importantly, those within our hearts and minds. Help us indeed to be people of faith, people of mercy, people of grace. Lord, hear us, Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, we believe that you love the world so much that you gave us the gift of Christ, your Son. And Lord, we continue to pray for this world, pray for you to raise up peacemakers, justice keepers, people of integrity and truth. And Lord, we pray that there would indeed be a great challenge against those who would wage war against their fellow human beings. Lord, we long for peace. Lord, we give thanks for our Ukrainian families who have come and worship with us. But Lord, we long for the day when we can send them home to a place of peace and security, and that they would know your blessing on them and their lives. Lord, we pray for the aid agencies and those who bring relief, that they indeed would find ways to reach those in greatest need at this time. Lord, we believe that you are the one who could change things in an instant, but for some reason you choose to work through us. So strengthen your people, bring about justice and peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
And Lord, we pray for our own nation. We pray for the turmoil within governments and the debates and the arguments that take place. Lord, again we pray for those who hold position of responsibility and powers, that they would have wisdom and yield that power with truth and mercy and justice. Lord, we pray, Lord, for an end of the stupid bickering between different parties and a deepening of a desire to work together for the goodness of each other. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
And Lord, we pray for your church throughout the world, but here in this area. We continue to pray for all the different branches, all the different members of your great family. Continue to bind us together and help us to find ways of working together. And so we pray in this coming week for the barbecue in Dalkeith as the churches come together and offer the people of the town a free gift of a barbecue, but also that greater free gift of your gospel. We pray too, Lord, for the work here in Bonnyrigg, for Josh, our new town youth worker, for his work with the young people and the youth fellowship, but also for the new initiatives of Toasty Tuesday being open to the high school to offer a place of safety and welcome to young people to come. Lord, we pray for your hand upon the work of your churches in this area. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
Lord, we take a moment for each of us to bring our thoughts, our hearts, our prayers, our needs and desires before you. Hear us as we pray. especially for Annie and her family as Anne moves into nursing care. May that be a blessing to her and to Sandy, Anne and Ben and the wider family. For others like Jane and Dorothy and Mary, Lord, that they would know care and love around them. We pray too for our families and friends, for those awaiting results of operations or waiting appointments, and pray, Lord, that in time healing and strength would come. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, as we come to your table, let us know afresh your mercy, your kindness and grace, that you welcome us in with the wonder of love and the power of grace.
Please stand if you're able. We meet in the name of the Prince of Peace. Let us share God's peace. Peace be with you. And your soul be with you. Offer to him which is bestowed for the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
us present our offerings to the Lord.
Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own we take it.
The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
Worship and praise belong to you, Father, in every place and at all times. You made us all the people of the world and everything that is. You give us the daylight and your word lights up our minds. Your Spirit lives in us, so that we can look at the world with your eyes. And one day, we will be with you in heaven. But already we laugh with the saints and the angels and sing their song. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest. Please feel free to sit again as we continue to pray. Father, you never forget us or turn away from us, even when we fail you. You sent your Son Jesus, who gave his life for us. He healed those who were sick and cared for those who were poor, cried with those who were sad. He forgave sinners and taught us to forgive. For all your love, we give you thanks in the way that Jesus showed us. For on the night before he died, while he was having supper with his friends, he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body. It is broken for you." After supper, he took the cup. He offered you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." We do this in remembrance of him who opened his hands of love upon our cross, who died and was buried for us, and rose again, defeating sin and death, that we might live. Hear us, most merciful Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us. And beyond this bread and this wine, that they may be the body and blood of Christ, and that sharing your life, we may travel in your company to our journey's end. With all your people, we give you thanks and praise through the Son and in the Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The living bread is broken for the life of the world. Lord, unite us in this time. And as our Saviour Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Through faith, through mercy, through grace, come to the feast. There is room at the table. Come, let us meet in this place with the King of all kindness, who welcomes us in with the wonder of love and the power of grace. Come. All are welcome at God's table.
Thank you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious, and his mercy endures forever. Father, may we who have received your grace and mercy live in the unity of your Holy Spirit and be empowered to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Please stand for our closing hymn, "And Can It Be That I Should Gain?"
And can it be that
tradition, so I'm told that we'll have to notice Jesus. The vestries of the churches are meeting soon, and if you're on the vestry, please take note of the meeting. And if you wish to observe the vestry meeting, you're welcome to do so, just let us know, and we'll accommodate you. As I said, this Friday and Saturday in Kings Park in Dalkeith, there's a Churches Together barbecue being run, and we welcome you to come and participate in that, or to take part. I think there are still some sign-up sheets at the back if you're able to give to come and help on the Friday or the Saturday. We're looking forward to that event. On Thursday evening, there's an act of worship at St John's Kings Park, bringing the team of people that are involved together as a small act of worship, to pray and to praise together, and then breaking up into teams that people will use in each team kind of thing. So you're welcome to come to that. We also let you know that the dates for Spring Harvest. For people who go to Spring Harvest, is the 1st to the 5th of April. And hallelujah, once again, it's after Easter. So it's called Up and Alive, Living the Life We Are Made For. I'd love to see me in the morning. Anyway, all that's happening. I don't know about any other Jackie.
It's not a notice, I just wanted to point out.
Excellent.
Four children who spent 40 days in what to them must be a wilderness.
Yes. Give thanks for that. Amazing. Mm-hmm. Yes. I don't think our kids can do that without a mobile phone and a Wi-Fi access. Some children are still brought up to look after themselves. So I should say this. Anyway, my thanks to all for that. I think a lot of you are aware that Grace had a graduation yesterday on Friday, and thanks and appreciation to that. She continues to give us all in wonder as she aspires to be the young lady that she is. So thank you for your love and your support. And we've passed it on to her, and she goes, "Ooh, don't like all this stuff." And this stuff. Anyway, must be time for a coffee.
So on behalf of the congregation, can we thank Alison and Fiona for arranging the cream teas that we had yesterday? It was a great day, the sun was out, the fellowship was fabulous, as you know, it was chock-a-block, and I'm afraid our diets have all suffered. But thank you very much, Alison and Fiona.
So Alison's next social event that she's organising is Couch to 5K.
I'll stay in the couch.
Yeah. I'm still exploring the couch as well. Anyway, let's gather for some tea and coffee and refreshments in the hall.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.